Hi everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I'm going to share with you a video on how I did a bathroom makeover on a budget. So in this video, I'm going to show you how I had to declutter my bathroom and remove molds from the walls. Like, I literally had to clean them and how I then finally did the makeover. Painting the walls was not an option, for this is a rental, so I just had to make do with what I can. At the end of the day, I'm the one who's going to be spending a lot of time in this bathroom. So enjoy this video. If you have probably watched my previous video on the first move or the interior decor on a bachelor's flat, you can definitely tell that this is not the same bathroom. I moved from that place and I moved into a smaller place because I decided to degrade and save more than to be paying a lot in rentals. So, well, this is some of the things that one has to go through if you decide to degrade. So this rental had all the features that I wanted, except for, you know, some minor things that I knew I had to work on. If you've watched my previous videos, you can also attest to that. So this is one of the projects. I just moved into this place, and then when I finally got here, I realized, okay, these walls need some work to be done. At first, I didn't know what the black stuff on the walls was, and then later on, that's when I realized that, no, these are molds. So I did a bit of research on how one can get rid of molds, and one of the ways you can get rid of molds is using white vinegar. So when I first moved into the place, I literally just took everything that's supposed to be in the bathroom into the bathroom. And I just had to think of how I was going to organize everything. So what I first did was I just moved everything into the bathroom. And then I gave myself time to think on how I was going to organize the bathroom. I didn't even have a curtain. And unfortunately for me, I realized the window is see-through. So for the time being, I had to put a throw to cover the window so that people outside cannot see me. So this is how my bathroom initially looked. There's that little space there where you can actually put things, but it was so cluttered. Like, you know, it's so untidy and it's just so not visually appealing. So in my mind, I was just like, no, I need to sort this out. So I took my time. Gave myself time to settle down, and then one weekend I cleared the whole bathroom, took everything out. I should also let you guys know that this is almost like a bachelor's flat. It's a self-contained flat, so you know, you just have to make do of all the space that you have so that everything will fit and it will be more homely. So I took out everything, literally cleared everything out, and then I started with having to remove the molds. That was not easy, I don't want to lie. So what I first did was I sprayed the white vinegar. How I prepared the mixture was I put 3 parts white vinegar and 1 part water. Then I sprayed the white vinegar, the mixture, with a spray bottle. I sprayed it onto the walls, and then using a cloth initially, I decided to wipe off the molds. I think those molds have been accumulating for, I don't know for how long, like, to be honest. And I also realized that it was just not molds. It was a mixture of molds and dust. And I think it's because maybe the previous tenants would leave the bathroom window open, and that resulted in dust also accumulating on the walls. So it really needed some elbow power, I don't want to lie. I had to scrub those walls. I gave it my all. I scrubbed those walls with the life in me. It took me a while. I think it took me the whole morning. I only finished maybe around midday. So initially, I started off with the cloth and the mixture of of white vinegar and water. Yes, it was getting the job done, but then when I then realized that no, it's not just molds, there's dust, I decided to also incorporate soapy water and a brush to make sure that the walls were like really clean, because some of the stains were difficult to remove.
Thank you.
this is the outcome. And then I got rid of that throw that I had initially, and I made a satin white curtain. It was not easy to make a white satin curtain, and that's like a rod curtain. But I wanted it to pop out and to be, like, as you can see, my walls are gray. So I decided to make it white, and I went for satin because it's shiny. So that would further sort of like give light and color to the space. And I got that shoe rack. I've always had it, but it really came in handy because there was no way I was going to be having shoes on the other side. There's no space in the other big room, so I had to put my shoe rack in the bathroom. So there's my curtain. And you know, when you've got small space, you just have to make use of every space you have. So I heaped all my extra toilet paper there and put a storage box on top. And I added a little candle by the side of the toilet pot, did a little bit of deco. Now that I'd decluttered, there was actually space for me to do deco. So this is how the curtain looked. I really love it. I made it myself. I'll do a video on how to make a rod curtain. It was the first curtain I've ever made, and I don't want to lie, it was very easy. So to declutter that little platform where I was just leaving everything, I decided to make fabric storage boxes with the leftover satin material. And for it to blend with the colors of my bathroom, I decided to make the inside navy blue, so that and you know, also navy blue is good because since they're going to be storage boxes, even if something leaks or powder falls onto, it's not going to be stained that much. So yeah, I decided to make that navy blue. And so this is the final look. I also threw in a little bit of deco accessories here and there. And then I added a shower curtain. When I moved in initially, there was like a white shower curtain that was like really filthy, which I got rid of. And I put my own shower curtain with blue polka dots. So as you can see, it's just contrasting with all the colors in the bathroom. I was like so happy with the final outcome of my project. And to also further cater for storage, I got a hook, a row with hooks from Pep, where I've decided to put all my handbags and my morning gown, since storage is really much of a hassle in this place. So you know, I try to make use of everything, every space, every place that I can turn into storage. So this is the final outcome of my project. And I also decided to lit my scented candles to just kind of give a good scent in the bathroom. I do light them once in a while when I'm just in the mood. So yeah, thank you for watching till the end. This is the final look of how my bathroom looked after I'd done the makeover. I'd cleaned the walls and decluttered all the clutter that was in the bathroom. And for those who want to know how I made those fabric storage boxes, I'll share a video with you later in the future. They were not really difficult, and I had to make them fabric because the platform where they're sitting on is not very, as you can see, the width is very small. So if you put something like a reed storage box, it would definitely fall off if someone passes. So I decided to make smaller fabric storage boxes that are to the specific measurements of that platform. So thank you for watching, and please do not forget to click on the subscription button and to click on the notification bell.